Hello everyone, I am going to explain question number first from exercise 7.6 from class 12. So the question number first is verify the Rolle's theorem for the following functions. So we have to verify the Rolle's theorem. So before moving to the questions, I want to explain Rolle's theorem. In Rolle's theorem, there are mainly three conditions: that the function should be continuous in the closed interval, and the function should be differentiable in the open interval, and the lower means function's value at the lower interval, lower limit, and function's value at the upper limit should be same. If any function is satisfying these three conditions, then Rolle's theorem is applicable. Then at any point in between from the interval f dash, at that value is going to be zero. So we started. And here the we'll start by the A part of question number first. A part is fx is equal to ex bracket sin x minus cos x. So mainly the fx is formed by the three functions, exponential function and the trigonometric function, ratio sin x and cos x. So we can say that the function is the sum and product of these three functions. So now we'll start it. As we know that ex, sin x and cos x are continuous and differentiable for each real number. So students, we know that the three functions, that is exponential function, sin x and cos x, are continuous as well as differentiable for every real number. That's why for all the real number which belongs from 5.4 to 5.4, these three functions are defined, well defined. That's why fx is continuous in closed interval as well as it is differentiable in the open interval. So first two conditions is satisfied. Now why it is so? Because fx is sum and product of continuous function. So like this, it's sufficient to write down like this. You don't have to actually prove that it is continuous or differentiable. If you know that the function, whatever functions they had used are continuous as well as differentiable, then you can write like this. Now we'll move to the third condition of Rolle's theorem, that is the function's value at the lower limit and function's value at the upper limit. So lower limit is 5/4 and upper limit is 5/4. So when we substitute 5/4 in given function, it's going to be this e 5/4 as it is. Sine 5/4, you know, 1/√2, and it's 1/√2. Now 1/√2 minus 1/√2 is 0. 0 multiplied by any number is 0. So function's value at the lower limit is 0. Now at the upper limit, that is 5/4. So this 5/4 we can split as 5 plus 5/4. Now because of 5 plus 5/4, it moved to the third quadrant, and in third quadrant, you know, sine and cos are negative. So and since it's pi, so you not have to change the trigonometric ratio, it's going to be sine only, but it is in third quadrant, that's why sine is negative, sine 5/4, and it's also going to be negative, so minus minus plus sine, so plus cos 5/4. Now write the values, so you again minus 1/√2 and plus 1/√2 is 0, so 0 multiplied by any number is 0. So what we obtain, function at lower limit and function at upper limit, values are same, so all conditions of Rolle's theorem is satisfied. Now if all conditions are satisfied, then what we have to do is first write the given function, differentiate, and when you will differentiate, since it's the product of two functions, that this is first function, this is second function, so when we differentiate, first I differentiated here ex, so differentiation of ex, and I kept this as it is. Then ex as it is, and I differentiated this bracket. So when we differentiate this bracket, sin x differentiation is cos x, and cos x differentiation is minus sin x, that's why plus sin x. Means I differentiated with the help of u dot v. Then ex is common, so take ex common. So in the bracket, you are remained with this. So when you differentiated, you obtained this. Then since all three conditions of Rolle's theorem is satisfied, so Rolle's theorem suggests that in this situation, f dash g is 0. Now we have to find out at which value of c the given function's differentiation is 0. So instead of x, what we have here? C. So the here x is replaced by c and keep it equal to 0. So from where we got this? From the Rolle's theorem. Now we have to find out here c, and c must belongs between the interval. So when we solve it, these are constants, so it coefficients, so it will go here become 0, so we will get sin c is 0. Now sin c is 0, so c value is going to be n pi. Now n is from the integer, integer means 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 like this. Now from here we will select the favorable value of c which belongs in the open interval which is mentioned in the given question. So pi belongs between this, that's why Rolle's theorem is satisfied for the given function. Now we move to the question number B. In question number B, the given function is x minus a to the power m and x minus b to the power m, and given interval is cross interval a to b, and here m and n are natural numbers. So natural numbers means they can't be negative as well as 0. Natural number starts from 1. Now since m and n belongs to the natural number, so as I mentioned, they can't be negative as well as 0. So this is also a polynomial. X minus a to the power m is also a polynomial, and x minus b to the power n is also a polynomial. So these both are the binomial. So by using the binomial, so fs is going to be a polynomial of degree m plus n. Why m plus n? Because they are in multiply, so when you will add the power, you will get m plus n. So here we have to write down, since m and n belongs to the natural number, so by binomial theorem we can say that fx, that is this fx, is a polynomial of degree m plus n, because when we multiply then the power gets x, so m plus n. So its degree is going to be, maximum power of this polynomial is going to be m plus n, since it's a polynomial. And you know students, polynomial function is continuous as well as differentiable for every real number. So some concepts should be very clear before Rolle's theorem, that polynomial function is always continuous as well as differentiable for any interval. That's why first it is mentioned, as we know that each polynomial function is continuous as well as differentiable for every real number. So now these are the Rolle's theorem's condition: fx is continuous in the closed interval and fx is differentiable in the open interval which is mentioned in the question. Now two conditions satisfied. Now we'll find out that fx value at lower limit and fx value at the upper limit. Since fx is this, so when we'll find out its value at a, x we have to replace by a, wherever x is there, replace it by a. Students, here mistake is there, you write here a. So you will get here a minus a is 0, 0 multiplied by any bracket is going to be 0. So function's value at lower limit is 0. Now function's value at upper limit, that is b. So instead of x, the substitute here b. So here also it's mistake, this right here also b. Sorry students, here a will come and here b will come, so do these changes. So you will get here, then again b minus b is 0, so 0 multiplied by any in the bracket is 0. So we obtained that the function value at lower limit is also 0 and function value at upper limit is also 0. That's why f a is equal to f b. So all conditions satisfied. That's why we will find out the derivative of fx. First derivative, so we differentiate it with respect to x. So it is again in the form of u dot v. That's why first I differentiated this by assuming it as x to the power n, that is n x n minus 1. Then chain rule we have to apply. So when you will apply the chain rule, you will get 1 only. Then this bracket as it is. Then by differentiated this bracket, that is n x n minus 1, and I kept this bracket as it is. So to differentiate it, I use the formula u dot v. So when we differentiate it, after differentiation, we can see that x a bracket power n minus 1 and x minus b bracket power n minus 1 are common, so take it common, so you are remained with this. Now after this step, what the Rolle's theorem says, that if all three conditions any function satisfy, then b we can have f dash c equal to 0. So f dash c is 0. So in f dash x is decided on f dash c. So wherever x is there, we have to write down c and keep it equal to 0. So we will obtain this. Now here these two terms are in multiples. So when it will go here, it becomes 0. So we will obtain only this bracket as 0. Now simplify it. Open the bracket and simplify and get the value of c. So when you will obtain c is mb plus na upon m plus p. So students, from coordinate geometry we can see that c belongs between a and b. So that's why Gauss theorem is satisfied. Hence question number first, a part and b part completed here. So I hope no Gauss theorem is clear to you. So Gauss theorem I have mainly three conditions: that the function should be continuous in the mentioned closed interval, and second condition is the function should be differentiable in the open interval, and function's value at lower limit and function's value at upper limit should be equal. And if any function is satisfying these three conditions, in that situation f dash c equal to 0 and c belongs between the open interval which is mentioned in the given question. So by keeping these conditions of Gauss theorem, solve it and you will get the answer. Thank you.